What's up? We're back again with Phobia. I am feeling much better, feeling a bit more positive, and I was able to put in this video today. Now, obviously, I traced it. I first did the sketch in my sketchbook, and then I decided to do a quick trace because I didn't really want to make much mistakes, and let's face it, I'm lazy, and I always look for the easiest way out of everything. Oh, and my phone fell down just now when I was videoing. Now, today we're going to be talking about arachnophobia and what is arachnophobia? Extreme irrational fear of spiders. Dun dun dun. Yes, those scary, buggy, multiple eyes creature that skittle around on all eight of their legs. By the way, there's a horror story about my brother found a spider with 10 legs. I think it was something like that. You should definitely go check that out. That is an amazing horror story. And I can give you many, many more creepy, scary story that involves spiders, bugs, or anything around that sort. And it's not just spiders that creep me out, it's also bugs, because they're weird with their legs and how they move. And if you ever had one crawling your skin or examine it close up, they have these hairy things on their eggs. Why am I seeing their eggs? They have these hairy things on their legs, and it's like sticky, and it feels weird for them to walk on your skin like that. And they have multiple legs and sometimes multiple eyes, and it is not nice seeing them. Could you just imagine lying there and having so many spiders walking all over you, crawling over your face, your eyes, trying to peer to get into your mouth, crawling into your ears, up your nose? God, you know, what if they started crawling into your eyes, like they started pushing their way to the back of your eyes? I am crawling out of my skin right now thinking about those stuff. Now, what causes arachnophobia? Symptoms of arachnophobia includes intense anxiety, avoidance of places known for having spiders, sweating, and increased heart rate. While there's no single cause for arachnophobia, scientists believe the main three reasons are evolution, cultural background, and personal experience. Now, I've never really had a scary experience with spiders. I just know that I don't like them. Cultural background. So I am Indian mixed with Amerindian. For those of you who don't know what Amerindian is, it is Native American. I don't think any of those two people have an issue with spiders. When I was small, and my sister was also small, she used to pick up beetles and let them run in her hand. And I'm not the only person in my family that's afraid of spiders. I have older cousins who are afraid of spiders too. So I'm not alone when it comes to the fear of spiders. So yeah, maybe it's a family thing passed down onto us that we're afraid of these crawling things. And I found out that spiders shed their exoskeleton like snakes. You know how snakes would shed their skin when they get bigger? So spiders can shed their skin. And so if you see like this dead, empty shell of a spider and you think, oh, it probably died of natural causes. No, it did not. It grew bigger, and you're looking at its skin there. I remember one night I was up watching videos on the chair, and all of a sudden I saw something scurry past the ground. My feet was up on the chair, thank God, because where my feet would have been on the ground, that's exactly where it ran past. And it stopped for a brief moment, and I don't really know if it was looking at me or not, but it just stopped there for a brief moment, and then it scuttled into the room. And it was this huge spider. I don't know what type of spider it was, but it was just this huge black spider. And I don't know what happened to it, but I don't want to know. I'm hoping he crawled out the window. I really am hoping he just scurried his little spidery butt all the way out the window. So we already get arachnophobia refers to the intense fear of spiders, or spider phobia. While it's not uncommon for people to dislike arachnids or insects, phobias of spider can have a far more significant impact on your life. A phobia itself is more than just a fear. Now, I remember one time I was on the bed and a spider
kind of like scuttled past the table, and I started screaming, and I pushed my cousin off the bed, and I was, it was coming towards me. It really was coming towards me, and I tried to back up. That caused me to back into the door, hitting my elbow, and I was still trying to get away, and I just kept kicking and screaming, and it ran the other direction. I definitely scared it away, but I ended up hurting my elbow really bad, and I hurt the side of my back really bad too. It was kind of black and blue, but my cousins definitely laughed at me for that one, because it was creepy and scary. And I think I had the same reaction to a cockroach once. The cockroach came close to me. Like, if I see a flying cockroach, I start screaming. I don't care, I want it killed. I am not having any living thing that scares the God out of me in this house. I don't want it there. I hate them. I hate everything about them. They're terrifying. I don't know why they're so terrifying. I mean, most of them are harmless, but they are terrifying for me. Them and their little legs and their beady little eyes. It's just creepy. So at least 30% of Americans have a fear for spiders. We're not living in America. We're living in Guyana right now. So I don't know the percentage of Guyanese that are afraid of spiders, but at least 30% of Americans are. So, you know, there's a percentage. According to a new study published in Biological Psychiatry, just 2 minutes of therapy could eradicate the fear. Oh, just 2 minutes of therapy could eradicate the fear? I wonder what they're doing in that fear. For most people, arachnophobia does not interfere with everyday life. No, it doesn't interfere with my everyday life. I can go about it every single day, but it's just that when I see one, I freak out, and it's not often that I see them. Oh, the really small ones, they don't really freak me out that much. Like, hey, you keep your distance, I keep my distance, and we cool. But you come close to me, I don't care how tiny you are, I'm hitting, I'm knocking, I'm kicking, I just want to kill it. I don't want it anywhere near me. I don't want it touching me. I just hate them. Now, could arachnophobia kill... Wait, how does arachnophobia kill spiders? That's a nice one. 11 ways to kill spiders, as explained by someone who's terrified of spiders. Squish it with a tissue. I usually try to squish it with anything that I can reach out and touch it, and not just with a tissue. So when it comes to squishing it with a tissue, that means I'm gonna have to get up close with it to squish it. I'm not looking forward to that. Step on it with a thick work boot. Yeah, you could step on it. Place a cup over it and hope that it suffocates. No, I'm not gonna peel it. I'm not gonna touch it. I hate it. I don't like it. That doesn't mean I want to torture it and kill it. Place a cup over it and call someone to come over and kill it. Yeah, that sounds more like it. Vacuum it up. Will it survive in the vacuum? Like, I know I don't like it. I hate it. But I don't want to torture it. Like, it didn't do me anything. I don't want to torture it. I just want it gone. Spray it with red. Okay. Spray it with a hairspray. What is hairspray going to do? Like, is it gonna give it a fabulous new look? No. Also, hairspray is flammable, so I'm not spraying it with hairspray. We can do what kills a spider instantly, but I'm pretty sure stepping on it would kill it instantly. So, you know, that one's not really such a good thing. It's not really something that we're going to be thinking about. Can spiders sense humans? Generally, spiders that move around in the open are out looking for prey or a mate. They are not out searching for a human to bite, despite how you might feel. How do spiders behave around humans? Humans create vibrations that spiders sense and use them. I'm sorry, what are they being warned against? Like, what exactly, who's warning who there? Is the spider warning us, or are they warning themselves? Like, What with that statement? Anyway, spiders in your bed. If you're afraid of spiders, then the thought of having them crawl on you when you sleep is terrifying. But there are plenty of stories circulating about spiders crawling on you during your sleep and even finding their way into your open mouth. But is there any truth to these claims? In order to figure out if spiders crawl on you during your sleep, you need to learn about what spiders want and how they behave around humans. Knowing the answer to these questions will give you more insight on the typical behaviors of spiders and may even help you sleep a little more soundly. Get a netting, and netting will help you sleep a little bit more soundly. The spiders won't get in, mosquitoes won't get in, cockroaches won't get in, there's a whole lot of list of things that won't get in. Get a netting. What do spiders want? Spiders come into your home for two main things, shelter and sustenance. They will spend the majority of their time in your home focusing on these two things. Often they find an out-of-the-way place like corners and behind furniture to spin their web. If the spiders in your home do not have luck catching prey in their spot, they choose to build a web. Then they will move around to look for better locations. At certain times, you may also see spiders out and about looking for a mate. Generally, spiders that move around in the open are out looking for prey or a mate. They are not out searching for a human to bite, despite how you may feel. Okay, that's a little nice to know. How do spiders behave around humans? In general, spiders try to stay away from humans. We do not have anything to offer them in the way of food or shelter. If you encounter a spider in your house, you are simply getting in its way as it is out searching for shelter, food, or a mate. Humans create vibrations that spiders sense and use them as a warning sign. For example, when we sleep, our breathing, heartbeat, and snoring can all create vibrations that deter spiders. The vibrations we cause by moving around the house doing our daily tasks may also keep spiders mostly out of sight. Well, it seems spiders are afraid of us just like we're afraid of them. It also seems like they don't want to harm us, they just want to go about doing their business. But then they're in our house, so I think that's also in our way too. And like, if they're the poisonous one, they're in our house and we encounter them, and if they bite us, like, I still don't want to think about it. I still think they're evil little creatures. So, do spiders actually crawl on you when you sleep? The vibrations that you put off during sleep are generally enough to deter spiders from crawling into the bed or on you during the night. They are, of course, exceptions, but if a spider does end up in your bed, it is more likely an accident or the only path towards something they are going after. Experts agree that spiders in your bed or in your mouth are unlikely and not worth worrying about. Now that you know spiders typically stay out of your bed, does that mean you no longer care if they crawl around your house? Of course not. There is a level of comfort to the idea that spiders actually avoid your bed at night, but the highest level of comfort comes from being in a house that is spider-free. You can keep your home spider-free by minimizing the clutter, dealing with other types of pests that attract spiders, and getting regular scheduled pest control service for your home. Now that we're coming to the end of the video, I just like to wrap this up with saying I hope you guys enjoy this video and that you find it very very helpful, especially when it comes to dealing with your phobia. Hope you leave a like and subscribe. Bye. Oh, and don't forget to turn on notification for more.